And there is President Trump down in Florida yesterday, about to head to the golf course. Couple thumbs up. Mostly quiet, though, this weekend. But we're joined now by one of his top defenders in the House, the top Republican on the House Oversight Committee, Jim Jordan. Congressman, thank you for joining us this morning. You heard Chairman Schiff right there. He says the fact that there are no new indictments is not necessarily vindication for the president. You agree?
Well, we got to read the report. But what I do know is, to date, not one bit of evidence to show any type of coordination, collusion, conspiracy between the Trump campaign and Russia to influence the election. And that was the charge, George, when this thing started almost 2 years ago. The Democrats were all saying that the president of the United States worked with a hostile foreign country to steal the election. And again, there has not been one bit of evidence to suggest that any of that happened.
Well, there's been a fair amount of evidence that 14 associates of Trump had over 100 contacts with the Russians, even though you're quite right, there was no charge of conspiracy. Does any of the information that's been revealed about those contacts or about the fact that so many in the Trump world lied about those contacts concern you?
Well, I mean, look, the central charge of the special counsel was to see if there was conspiracy, coordination, or collusion between the Trump campaign and Russia to impact the election. As I've said, that was the focus of the entire special counsel investigation. We've not seen any of that. And again, remember, this is Bob Mueller. This was the guy the Democrats and the Republicans, everyone in town said, this is the guy we need for the job. He is the best person we can pick. He is right next to Jesus. He can almost walk on water. This is the guy. And he will have the definitive statement on that fundamental question. We'll see the report. But all indications are that there's not going to be any finding of any collusion whatsoever.
How about the other concern that one of the other concerns that Chairman Schiff raised right there, the fact that President Trump might be compromised because he was pursuing that Trump Tower in Moscow during the campaign, not telling the truth about it, may still be pursuing it today.
Come on, George. I mean, look, here's what's happened. They don't think this Mueller report's going to be the bombshell they all anticipated it was going to be. So now they're launching all kinds of other charges, all kinds of other investigations. They bring in Michael Cohen a few weeks ago. This was their first big hearing, their first star witness, their first announced witness of the 116th Congress, a guy who's going to prison in 6 weeks for lying to Congress. They bring him in, and what does he do? He lies again. We think at least seven times under oath in front of the Congress again. So that didn't work for him. Now what's Chairman Nadler do? 81 different letters to 60-some different individuals, starting a whole new fishing expedition. This is how they operate. So if it's not the bombshell they wanted, they bring in Cohen. That doesn't work. That hearing is a flop. Then they go with Chairman Nadler and 81 different letters sent out there. This is how the Democrats are going to operate. We just got to be used to it and understand that that's where they're going to go.
Do you stand by your vote that the country should see, Congress should see the entire Mueller report?
The Attorney General was clear in his letter. It was a short letter Friday, but there was a lot of important things he said in there. He said he's going to consult with Rod Rosenstein. He's going to consult with the special counsel, Bob Mueller, and he's going to release as much as he possibly can, consistent with the law. I think the Democrats should be, that should be what we all want, an Attorney General who operates according to the law. So I'm for erring on the side of transparency.
Bill Barr voted to have the whole thing released. You didn't have those qualifications in the vote.
Yes, we did, consistent with the law. That's what we want. And I think the Democrats would want the same thing, too. But I'll tell you this, George. If he's going to release all the information, then I want all of it released. I want those 302s. I want the conversations between Bruce Ohr and Christopher Steele, the guy who wrote the dossier, Glenn Simpson, the guy the Clinton campaign hired to put the dossier together. I want all those conversations that Bruce Ohr had with Glenn Simpson, Christopher Steele, those recorded those notes from the FBI. I want all that made public.
So you agree.
The FISA application to be made public. When they used that dossier, took it to a secret court, didn't tell the court the Clinton campaign paid for that document, didn't tell the court a foreigner who was desperate to stop Trump from being elected president wrote the document. I want that information released, too. So if they're going to release everything, let's release it all.
Well, let's just be clear on that, then. So you agree with the Democrats all the underlying documents should be released, top to bottom. The Mueller report should be released. We've just gone through the special counsel regulations. There's nothing in the law that precludes the Attorney General from releasing all of that.
I'm saying that the Attorney General should follow the statute. And that's what he's indicated he's going to do in consultation with Rod Rosenstein and Bob Mueller. I think the Democrats should be happy with that. They said Bob Mueller was the guy that they wanted to do this investigation. Bill Barr is going to consult with him and decide what he can release. But if they do release everything, then by golly, release it all. Show us that FISA application. Show us the 302s. Show us the information they gave the Gang of Eight. The Gang of Eight, with Adam Schiff, was a part of that. The Gang of Eight, when they talked to them way back when about this dossier and about what took place at the FISA court and about the start of this counterintelligence investigation, show us all that information, too. The American people deserve. We've asked for that information to be made public a long time ago, because that goes to what these top people, this cabal at the top of the FBI, what they did when they launched this thing clear back in the summer and fall of 2016 before the election.
The president could order all this released on his own, all of it declassified on his own. Will you urge him to do that?
I've urged him to release the stuff I just described. I sure have. The stuff that Jim Comey, Andy McCabe, Jim Baker, Lisa Page, Peter Strzok, all the stuff that they had started with the dossier and all the stuff that they had started initially with this investigation prior to the election.
I've urged him to do that. Will you urge him to order the release of the Mueller report as well?
Again, that's the attorney general's call, and he's going to do that consistent with the law. All I'm saying is if the Democrats are going to call for all that to be released, then they should call for everything to be released.
I'm asking you a different question now. The president has this authority. Are you asking the president to order the release of the Mueller report?
That's the president's call. He said he wants it to be made public. He said that the other day when he was walking, I think, out to in front of the press. I think last Wednesday he said that. So that's the White House's call.
You mentioned the hearing with Michael Cohen a couple weeks back. As we know from the Southern District of New York, they concluded that President Trump was individual one who directed Michael Cohen to make those hush money payments to influence the election, essentially directed a felony. Does that concern you?
Look, like I said, Michael Cohen came in front of our committee, and he lied, we think, at least seven times. That's why Congressman Meadows and I sent a criminal referral letter to the Justice Department. We know he lied about his, when he said he didn't want a job in the White House, we know that was a lie. Every media outlet in the country had reported that
he did. But this was the conclusion of the Southern District prosecutors. They're the ones who said that individual one, President Trump, directed Michael Cohen to do this.
Well, I mean, they have their investigation that they're doing in the Southern District of New York. What I choose to focus on is the fundamental charge of the special counsel was to look at collusion. We have not seen any of that. What I also know is Michael Cohen cannot be trusted, and he proved that when he came back in front of the committee and several times lied under oath. I think the real question here is, will Chairman Cummings join us in demanding that Michael Cohen be charged for perjury by the Justice Department? I think he should do that. He was very clear at the start of the hearing. He said, Mr. Cohen, if you don't tell the truth, I'm going to hold you accountable. And we've seen nothing from Chairman Cummings to do any of that, any kind of holding him accountable at all.
So just to be clear, the president's involvement in those hush money payments doesn't concern you?
The president has had an amazing 2 years. He was in Ohio last Wednesday. And what I saw was people lining the street as he rode from the airport to the tank plant where we build the best tanks in the world. I saw people cheering him because they understand that this president is committed to fighting for the American people and getting accomplished the things he told the American people he was going to do. It was an amazing reception he received from all kinds of folks here in the 4th District of Ohio just last Wednesday.
Congressman Jordan, thanks for your time this morning.
You bet. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.